In this video, we'll provide a quick intro to the CAN-MOD GPS, our GPS-to-CAN module with 3D inertial sensor. We'll cover the key features, output signals, use cases, and a deep dive on the sensor fusion functionality. Let's start with a quick overview. In short, the CAN-MOD GPS is a standalone module that produces GNSS-related data and inertial sensor data. The data is broadcast through a CAN bus interface. The device is 100% standalone and can be integrated into any CAN bus system, including vehicles, machinery, and CAN data recording equipment. Let's look at some of the key features. First, the module is plug and play. Simply connect the device via the DB9 to provide input power and start outputting the sensor data through CAN. Second, the module comes in an extremely compact aluminum enclosure with 4 status LEDs. It weighs less than 70 grams and comes with a GNSS antenna as part of the bundle. The module uses the high-spec NEO M8U from uBlox and supports high-precision global GNSS positioning via combinations of GPS, Galileo, Beto, and GLONASS. The module also contains a built-in gyroscope and accelerometer for providing high-frequency 3D inertial sensor data like angular rates and acceleration rates. This IMU data is also used in a sensor fusion model to enable the device to provide precise precision-related data, even in GNSS hostile areas like cities and tunnels. Finally, the module can be easily configured via USB. Simply connect the device to your PC and use the free configuration editor tool to modify the CAN bus bitrate, the CAN IDs, the data frequency, and various sensor settings. Via the USB connector, you can also stream the CAN-MOD sensor data in real time to your PC for visualization in, for example, SavvyCAN. Next, let's take a look at the various sensor outputs provided by the CAN-MOD GPS. First of all, the module outputs the GNSS position in the form of longitude and latitude coordinates. Second, the module outputs speed, which can be used in, for example, vehicle telematics to identify speeding, idle time, asset utilization rates, and more. Third is altitude, which can be a key parameter in, for example, the analysis of fuel battery consumption in a vehicle, or in aerospace applications like drones and planes. Next is attitude. The CAN-MOD GPS uses the GNSS and IMU sensor fusion to provide attitude data like roll, pitch, and heading. This enables a complete 3D picture of the asset orientation at any given time. It also provides odometer data, which enables easy tracking of the distance traveled by the asset, both in total, since the last reset, and per trip, since the last power cycle of the device. In terms of the IMU, the module provides 3D angular rate data at 100 Hz, which can be used in the analysis of driving behavior and vehicle dynamics. It also provides 3D acceleration rate data at 100 Hz, which can be used in the analysis of road and driving quality, like speed bumps, harsh braking, etc. It can also be useful in predictive maintenance. Through the device configuration, you can also specify geofences, and the module will then output the status of these via CAN, which can be useful for theft prevention, safety improvements, process automation, and more. Finally, the device outputs a high-precision timestamp. This can be useful in linking historical date and time to the other sensor data. It can also be used for syncing the internal clock of connected CAN bus equipment. For each signal, the device also provides details on the validity and quality. To understand how the CAN-MOD GPS can be used in practice, let's look at two types of cases. First, the module can be integrated as a standalone device for injecting sensor data directly into the CAN bus of a vehicle or machine. The sensor data can be consumed by other CAN nodes on the network, for example, ECUs, cabin displays, CAN loggers, or telematics control units. To ensure compatibility, you can easily modify the CAN bitrate and CAN IDs via the configuration editor. Another popular use case is to deploy the CAN-MOD GPS as an add-on module for the CAN-Edge CAN bus data logger. To do so, you simply configure the CAN-Edge to provide a 5-volt power output via the second port, and then connect the CAN-MOD GPS via an adapter cable. This lets you record your vehicle or machine CAN data via Channel 1 and time-synced GNSS and IMU data via Channel 2. For example, you can use the CAN Edge 2 to collect both your vehicle and sensor data and send it to your own server via Wi-Fi or cellular access points. To end this introduction, we'll use the CAN Edge and our open source dashboard integration to illustrate the power of the CAN Mod GPS Sensor Fusion functionality, also called Untethered Dead Reckoning, or UDR. To demonstrate this functionality, we hooked up a CAN Edge 2 with two CAN Mod GPS units. In one unit, we disabled the sensor fusion, and in the other, we enabled it. Next, we drove through an underground parking lot, in other words, a highly GNSS hostile area. To review the data from this trip, we set up a quick Grafana dashboard overview. In the dashboard, we use orange to show data from the device without sensor fusion and blue for the other device. As we move into the parking garage, notice how the device without sensor fusion loses the GNSS fix entirely, which results in the position not being updated at all. In contrast, the device with sensor fusion retains a precise position through the underground garage trip until we reach the outside again. Importantly, it is not only the position that is enabled through sensor fusion. As evident, it also enables other key signals like speed, altitude, heading, roll, pitch, and odometer. Overall, the CAN Mod GPS is a powerful solution for providing high-precision GNSS and IMU data via CAN Bus in a compact and low-cost package. Go to our website to order your CAN Mod GPS today, or contact us if you have any questions.